Hello, my YouTube world. Johnny Moe coming to you today with Blade Talk. That's right. Fall's around the corner, so we're going to be talking about blades. We're going to be talking about how I set my ICD deck up, what seasons I run all three of these blades, and in this video, you may just find some tips that'll help you with your particular mower issues. All right, YouTube world, let's jump right into this because I love talking decks and I love talking blades. I love it. This is the meat of the mower is right here. The deck, the blades, and the deck I love decks. I love talking about decks. I love when you get yourself into a good mower and it has a great cutting deck and everything's flying out of there smoothly and you're just, wow, I love it. I just love it. So to start off the year in the spring, I use these. These are high lifts. They resemble much of the Exmark blade. But as you know, this blade here from other videos is from the old style Ferris deck before the ICD. These are the standard ICD 61-inch blades, standard. As you can see, that big fan right there, as opposed to that. That's how much more airflow is being created in that deck. There's probably a good reason for it because there's a lot of open space underneath there, especially in the discharge chamber. The discharge chamber opens up. My assumption is Briggs & Stratton needed to create a lot more airflow, so that's exactly why they did this. But in doing the airflow, what I've noticed is in the spring that these blades make a big mess on the lawns. The grass is already growing. It's already growing straight up in the air. You don't need a lot of lift. You just need to get the stuff out of the deck. But with this much airflow and this much more cutting capacity, what happens is a lot of extra grass is in that deck. And when it comes out, it ain't pretty. And I don't like looking at it, and it's hard to clean up. For some reason, the grass in the spring, this just cuts it and gets it out of the deck. There's less material. Now, let's go over this. Let's see why there's less material. First of all, I don't know if you've ever noticed that when you're cutting grass or when you're blade sharpening, notice that the cutting edge is usually right here is the dullest. Back here is we're still relatively sharp. That lets me know that this is doing the majority of the cutting. Same thing with here. As a matter of fact, you can almost see a little bit of an indent from here to here. From here to here, no indent. Doesn't even look like it's cutting. As a matter of fact, you can see that it's black here because it's not cutting, whereas this isn't. This is what's cutting. So that lets me know that this fan probably from here to here is what's doing the majority of the cutting. So that means there's a lot more material right there. So that's putting a lot of extra material into my deck that's doing the cutting. Now look at the difference. So if it's only cutting from here to here, that's less material. In the spring of the year when the grass is growing, it's full of chlorophyll, it's growing straight up in the air, this has no issue cutting whatsoever. It gets it, it cuts it, it gets it out of the deck. The problem is in the summer of the year, this does not generate enough lift to cut. In the Northeast, when you're dealing with fine fescues and bent grasses, as it gets into the 80s and it stays there, that grass wants to lay down. So when your tires and deck go over it, you have to have a mower deck that creates enough airflow to pick it up so it can be cut. This doesn't create enough airflow. So what happens is it looks laid down. Now, when you're done with the lawn, it looks cut. But a couple days later, you'll start to see it rise back up as it starts to grow. And then it starts to look bad. This does a much better job in the summertime picking it all up and cutting it. And makes it the aftercut appearance looks a lot better in the summer. Now, let's go over some blade basics here because to understand how these mulchers work, we got to understand how this works. So this is cutting. The cut grass flows into this lip and then boom, it's like a little glove. It just catches it and throws it on to the next chamber where it's whipped around and it's eventually from the trim side to the center blade to the discharge side. Eventually, it's just thrown over there. Well, with all that extra material from this blade being so wide, generating so much airflow, it just seems in the ICD deck that this creates a lot of extra grass in the deck. That's why when you pull out onto the road, say you're doing an angle cut and you're going to turn around on the road. I've noticed when I turn around on that road, man, it's still throwing out grass like I'm still cutting, but I'm on the road. Why? Because of all the extra airflow, it's keeping that grass in the deck too long. This gets it in there and gets it out of there and it's done. I don't have that problem with this blade. That's why this is a great spring blade. Works really well. In fact, it's out of the three, it's my favorite blade of them all. Just because it just keeps that deck clear. Boom, it's out of there. It's a better wet grass cutter. It's definitely better in the spring. These come off because this just makes a mess you can't clean up. It's just too much airflow. You don't need all that airflow in the spring because the grass is already standing erect. It's already full of chlorophyll. You just don't need that much airflow. So you need something with a little bit less aggressiveness, and it really shoots it out of there too. This is a great blade. I love this blade in the spring. So I use this from about April, probably about the first week in April, all the way to about the second week in June when that 80-degree weather starts to set in. That's when this blade comes in because of all that extra lift. It lifts it up, cuts it, throws it out of the deck. Works really well. So I use this blade all the way till probably around September. And what happens is that temperature starts to drop. It gets into the 50s at night. It starts to rain a little bit, and the grass wants to start growing through the roof again. So I put these on for about 3 weeks. After that, when leaf season fully hits in October, this is the blade I use. This is a G5. This is a G5 Oregon Gator blade. This is my favorite mulching blade out of everyone I've used. There's not much difference between this and the G6. The G6 is just a little bit heavier. And so I like this. Anything lighter makes my mulching experience easier. That's the way I like it. So let's go back here. I want to finish this video up talking about this particular blade. But right at this time, I want to give you the part number, the Ferris part number for these blades. These will also work on any 61-inch deck that you have as long as it's 61-inch. The part number is, stop the video or pause it, 502-0842. This is the Ferris blade from the original decks, the square nose decks. This is the ICD deck. This blade here has the smaller fin on it, and it's the 502-0842. So here you go. Pause it, write it down, and you can order this through Ferris. And that's the blade number for this, because this, I get this question all the time about this blade. So let's go over this blade. Why don't I use this blade in the springtime? Well, Ed Wright kind of hinted at it in his video when he was talking about cut quality. He was talking about airfoil versus blender. In the spring, the grass is filled with all kinds of juices, chlorophyll, it's wet, and so what these blades do is they keep the grass in the deck longer being chopped up, therefore using more horsepower. And also, but when it's wet, what grass likes to do is it likes to stick to each other. So by the time it's gone through all the chambers and starts to become discharge, what you get is little clumps. What I want, that's a blender. I don't like that blender. Exmark blends, Bobcat blends. I believe even the Wright mower, looking at the baffle system, blends too. I'm not a blender. Now, when it's dry out, it's nice to have those smaller pieces blown out across the grass. But I would say 70% of the times we're cutting in some bad cutting times. We're usually in the springtime, it's terrible. The summertime, it starts to ease up. And then right back in the fall, we're right back at it. So these blades here do not do a great job on the ICD deck in the spring. It just causes clumps. Having said that, so let's take a look at this blade. I use this to mulch up leaves. I put a shoot discharge blocker, a shoot blocker like you saw in my last video, and it shuts off that the opening, and then it stays in there and cuts it up more because I want to grind the leaves up to powder is what I want to do. These do a great job of doing that. As long as you're not overwhelming it to the point, that's when you just bag up whatever's left. So the grass is being cut. It hits this. It then flows back here. Because there's notches here, and everyone thinks, oh, these are mulching them. They're cutting. I'm sure a little bit of cutting goes on there, but not like what you're thinking. You're thinking that it's just chopping it and chopping it. What's happening is the grass is coming across the top part of this blade, falling between these little notches. One, two, three, four notches. And what's happening is when this blade is coming back around to cut, the grasses that are falling between there is being cut again, making it more chopped up. It's a great design, but again, it's causing a blender to happen in the deck of your thing. And if you're cutting wet grass, you want grass out of the deck. You don't want it in the deck because it's just going to stick to everything. And you're just making, you're making smaller grass pieces into little balls of just junk and clunk. And when it comes out of there, there's clumps everywhere. It's hard to clean up. It's just a mess. That's why when it's wet, I love to use these because it gets it, it cuts it and it gets it out of the deck fast. The problem is that the pieces are bigger and sometimes it leaves it a little hay. So I raise it up about a half inch to three quarters of an inch and boom, I go over it again. It cuts them up. It disperses them through the lawn. And 98% of the time, it does a great job. There are some times where it's too thick and you come back, oh, about a week later and you'll notice some like white marks in the lawn in the spring. Just because it didn't, couldn't break it down good enough. But those will go away. I've never had an issue. 98% of the time, this does the job. But there are some times where the grass is just too, too thick. And it's even worse with this. This is very, this blade here is very hard to, in the spring, to clean up the lawn. It just, too much grass overloads the deck. And it just comes flying out of there in clumps. I don't know why. I just assume because there's just so much material being cut off here and just thrown around in that deck. So much air volume in that deck. It's just holding grass at the top side of the deck. And then it starts to drop when there's nothing being cut and thrown out. It's just a mess. But in the summertime, this is the blade you want. It just does a great job of picking the grass up and cutting it, throwing it. But so leaf time, I want mulching. I want it to mulch. So I want the leaf to hit here. Go through here, come on the backside, have that blade come around and chop it up. Then go to the shoot blocker and hit the shoot blocker and get cut by that blade and block it all up and shred it. That's what I want. So in the fall, when I'm doing strictly leaves, probably the third week in October, these will go on the mower. And that's how I finish my year. And then the beginning of the year, I start the first 2 weeks out with them. So that's my blade talk. That's everything that I do to the ICD deck. Spring, summer, fall. That's basically how I do it. No one blade can handle the Northeast. You can use this in the summer. You're just going to have issues with the lawn being pushed down. You know, sometimes I've had customers come out and say, John, it just doesn't even look like it's cutting. Looks a couple days later, it just looks like it rises back up. And then they'll pick it up and they'll see that the grass is 12 inches tall because the deck's pulling it down, pushing it down. And it doesn't have enough chlorophyll and juices in it to pick it back up. It just stays down because it's limp. It's just the 85 degrees just tear it up. And that's the end of it. So that blade can no longer really be used. It can be used, just doesn't have a great aftercut appearance on fine fescue and bent grass. This here, it does a really good job on the fine fescue and the bent grass. And that's why it's in the summer. It lifts, cuts, much better appearance. This here is strictly for me. This is just a strictly leaf cutting machine. That's all I use these for. I want to mulch. I want to break down as much leaf material as I can. And that way I don't have to bag a lot and I don't have to throw a lot into my truck. I'd rather just leave it on site. I've been doing that for quite a while. These do a really good job. So again, part number for this blade here, 502-0842. Guys, that's my time. This is Blade Talk. I hope you enjoyed it. Have any question on these blades, please put them down in the comment section. And again, spring, summer, fall. I used three different blades for that ICD deck, and it works really, really well. Later.